Samsung Galaxy S21 Plus sounds like Samsung bought a company that makes OnePlus phones and created unholy union lineup, Galaxy OnePlus. That's some multiverse stuff, I might add. okay, now for real. S21 Plus, Samsung Galaxy. Pre-flagship and middle brother of an amazing phone, covered in controversies with charger, with SD cards and all of that stupid decisions. Still, it's cheaper, smaller and more beautiful. Yes, more beautiful, especially in this color, Phantom Violet. It absolutely smashes S21 Ultra in terms of elegancy, style and, as to say, finishment of a vision. It absolutely looks like a jewel made with milky amethysts with the fines of gold. It fits in hand much better. It feels in hand much better. Just simply stunning. I don't even care about other colors. This is lineup seller. Absolutely. And, which is funny, color scheme and price are not even the only advantages compared to S21 Ultra, believe it or not. S21 Plus drops 5x telephoto module, which was useless and only added cost. Thank you very much. Might I add, it would be much better even without 3x module, which, as I was told, and I still don't comprehend, is not even 3x optically. It's only 1.1. No joke. At other camera news, ultra-wide module with autofocus became one without one. Thanks, I hate it. Still, everything that's left here is pretty much as stellar a performer as flagship Go, including frontal camera, which is amazing. Okay, SoC. Exynos 2100 still trades punches with Snapdragon flagship, still lags in a temperature test, still comes far ahead in AI benchmarks, still awesome in games and in work, still is pretty energy efficient. Thumbs up. As for memory, my sample has 8GB of LPDDR5 RAM and 256GB of UFS 3.1 storage, which is, for all intents and purposes, minimal adequate capacity. Because, of course, it's nothing worse than SD card support final loss. 101 flagship, my dears. 2 SIM cards, 0 memory ones. I'm just kidding. No charger in the box too.
What's in the box?
No charger, I'm sorry.
No!
And while we are on charging, phone still supports 25. 15 and 4.5 watts of wired, wireless and reverse wireless charging. With a 4800 milliamp hours of a battery, we have about 6 hours in PCMag battery test on full brightness, full resolution and 120 Hz refresh rate. About the resolution and screen in general, you see S21 Plus compared to S21 Ultra got the most downgrades in screen division. Max resolution became FHD+, not WQHD+, peak brightness dropped from 15 to 1300 nits, display size came from 6.9 to 6.7 inches, and minimal frame rate is now 48, not 10 Hz. And you know what? Half of it is okay. FHD+, awesome. Less screen size, better handling. Less brightness, better energy efficiency. 38 Hz? Well, little more than 10, but still less than 60. No stylus support? Well, flagship things are for flagships. Just like Wi-Fi 6E, by the way. Everything else, including NFC, IP68, stereo sound, One UI 3.1, dynamic AMOLED 2X display, are included in S21 Plus. So, to recap, pre-flagship is a beauty. Not as technically powerful as flagship, but very close. Still, it costs a pretty penny. And I admit I was wrong. S21 Plus cost $70 more than S20 Plus did cost at the sales start. So, Samsung gives me less and less reasons to protect its stupid decisions. Well, c'est la vie. And what about you? Will you forgive Samsung for sins against the charger and memory card? Write it in the comments below. As usual, thanks Mebelock Shop for helping us with a place to make our videos. Link is in the description below and just like a link to a text review of S21 Plus, much and much more detailed. And while you are there, don't forget to like, subscribe and press notification bell so you won't miss any of our videos. My name is Denis Zaichenko with The Root Nation. See you next time.